SolidJS is a relative newcomer to the JavaScript framework scene, and yet it ranks first in popularity in this year's State of JavaScript survey. What makes it so attractive? And is it worth learning? It's like React at first glance. When you read SolidJS code, it looks a lot like React. A component is a function that returns JSX code. If you're at all familiar with React, you can read SolidJS code and get a good idea of what is going on. In fact, the following code is valid in both React and Solid. Function myComponent props return div hello props.name, close the div, close the function. And that's a good thing. There are already enough different frameworks, each pushing their own syntax. And React is the de facto standard. So it's nice to be in familiar territory. Except that it's not. Because hooks, which are the backbone of React's business logic, don't even exist in SolidJS. Solid doesn't have a useState hook. Instead, it relies on signals. What is a signal? In Solid, signals are initialized like this: const count, comma, setCount equals createSignal, 0. Given the familiar syntax, it's easy to imagine that createSignal is just a variation on React's useState. And in a sense, that's true. Both serve to solve the same problem, tracking the application state. So what's the difference between SolidJS's signals and React useState hooks? The first hint of a clue is that the first element returned by createSignal, so count in the example above, is a function. SolidJS's website states signals are event emitters that hold a list of subscriptions. What does that mean in practice? The documentation also states that component functions are called once and then cease to exist. They exist to organize your code and not much else. So despite the similarities in how the code is written, it feels like the underlying mechanisms are very different. React tracks state changes across the component tree using a virtual DOM. And then React re-renders the tree based on where the changes occur within the tree. The tree is compared and the component functions are called repeatedly. The whole component and its children are re-rendered whenever any part of its state changes. Solid, on the other hand, tracks which part of the UI depends on what, and it updates that and nothing else. And that feels very familiar. Svelte claims to be the vanishing framework. Instead of comparing state changes across a virtual DOM, as React and others do, it overloads the JavaScript syntax to track dependencies. In that sense, it's first and foremost a compiler. And because it knows which part of the interface depends on which variable, it is surgically precise in its updates. And what SolidJS is doing feels very similar to this. The parts of the interface that change are plugged into event listeners. The side effect, the use effect equivalents, plug themselves into these event listeners. So why not use Svelte or React instead of turning to some relatively new upstart? To me, and this may well be just a question of taste, Svelte feels too much like magic. It looks like JavaScript, but the compiler is laying on dependency dark arts on top of that. Solid, on the other hand, makes more sense than Svelte. It's just cleverly organized event listeners, not some magic with the compiler. Event listeners, I know, I understand, and I trust. Compilers doing strange stuff to my code that I don't understand, not so much. When you think about it, Solid even makes more sense than React. The mistakes I've seen junior developers make show they haven't grasped when functional components are called or how the state is managed. And in a sense, that's the hardest thing about SolidJS. Concepts that I've learnt about React that have become ingrained in the way I code, about how to manage state and the rendering, don't transpose well to SolidJS. I don't need to worry in SolidJS about how often components are called, because they're only called once. In both these cases, in how Solid implements reactivity and how it manages HTML rendering, Solid feels saner than its parents, Svelte and React. All this combines to produce code that is effective and fast. SolidJS scores very highly on the JavaScript framework benchmark. It's very highly regarded too in the State of JavaScript survey, and it weighs in at only 7 kilobytes. So why won't I be using SolidJS just yet? Well, part of the problem is that SolidJS just isn't React, and a lot of the projects I'm involved in already have a big React codebase. The people working on them know React, and they don't know Solid. But I have the feeling that here and there, bit by bit, where React was causing performance problems on projects where I can work alone, I'll be sprinkling in a bit of SolidJS here and there. And who knows, maybe someday I'll be using it exclusively. Because I love Svelte reactivity, but I'm not a fan of its compiler magic. And I love React's JSX syntax and simplicity, but I've seen too many people tripped up by behavior they don't understand. And SolidJS looks like it might be bringing together the best of both worlds in a way that is both simple, sane, and solid.